the word healer, if there is no life in it, it's not going to work. I'm talking deep things now. If you pay me attention, you might catch something that will help you from where you are to move to the next level. So those of you that are looking, trying to find God, in fact, stop praying if there's no presence. There are two things. If you're looking for me to do something for you, first of all, you find me, is it not? Then you tell me your problem. Then I go and do it. So we mix it in the church somehow. We are taught to pray, but we are not taught to look for God who answers the prayer. Then there is big problem. People are praying, there's no result. And at some point, they give up. The primary thing is finding grace. Grace is the one that answers prayers. So if you can find him, the book of 1 John says, if you know that he heareth you, he said, then you receive answer to your prayer. So he said, then I wait on my door daily. How? It's easy for someone to read it for you, but they should explain how. Do you get it? Everybody everywhere, they tell you be born again. But no one is telling anybody how to be born again. They bring you to altar call. You say, Lord Jesus, coming to me. Is that the end? Then you're on your own. They say there's deep things that until you get it, you will struggle. He said, then I wait on the door. When I open, they come in. So now, out of your belly, what you put in is the word. The Holy Ghost is the river. So what word do you need? Do you need to start seeing God? You need to start hearing him. Have you heard God all your Christian life? Say, my sheep know me. They hear me. So if you're his sheep, it's your legal right to hear, to know. So now you have received the baptism. Sometimes when the worship is going on, you fall under the anointing. That is an evidence that you have the baptism of the Holy Ghost. Paraventure, you don't know whether you have him or not. Praise the Lord. So now your job is to consciously put the word of God to work. When the river starts flowing, it's a channel. And what is in it is what works for you. Praise the Lord. So if you want to hear him, you pick up John chapter 10. Praise the Lord. John chapter 10. Can you people take that baby? Take the baby and let her be calm. Then you come in again. Praise the Lord. So now, what you put in is important. What the flow you get is what you are putting. Praise the Lord. So now we are talking about finding grace. Because a lot of people don't know how to find the Holy Spirit. But they are filled with the Holy Spirit. Praise the Lord. So if you're filled with the Holy Spirit, you need to know how to walk with him. He said, out of your belly shall flow. That's why you're praying for someone. The thing is not moving. Your stream is not flowing. Do we get it? The prayer you're praying to solve problem, the power comes from your spirit. So now you make your stream a flowing one, a living one. That means you have to receive it. Receive the life of Christ. Praise the Lord. I don't know if I'm making sense in what I'm talking. Because it's not about, some of you know me. They said that woman have problems, she prayed too much. I prayed if nobody is telling me I pray, I'm telling myself I pray in life. But if I've come to a point where I'm telling you, if you don't know what you're praying, there's a problem. Because you might pray and pray and pray and pray and pray and not get results. At some point, you tire out. Some point, you give up on God. But now, the prayer you're praying, God is going to honor it from within you. Do we get it? The Holy Ghost. Now, if you're praying, waiting for God in heaven, is the one that is within you that connects and bring back results for you. Are we getting it clearly? I know I'm talking mathematics now, for those who are not mathematicians. But it's a process that you decide to get. So now be sure you have received the baptism of the Holy Ghost. That's number one. Number two, apply the word of God. Tell him, Father, out of my belly shall flow rivers of living water. Pray in the spirit, speak the word. Tell him, Lord, I need a healing flow. Then, when the flow begins, you will know there's nothing that you, there's no way you can know. Then go and pray for the person that is sick. Do you get it? It's not suddenly they call you, pray, then you jump up, pow, you're praying, then you finish the prayer, you're looking, there's no change. You left your armor. He said, put on the whole armor. So now, for you to even go on that assignment, you have to put on your gadget, put on, take on everything you need. Before you left your house, daily, it's not enough to say, Father, protect me. Go ahead of me. Yes, it's a good prayer. Do you get it? Now, what do you want him to show up as? The whole of that day. Do you want him to come as peace? Because do you want him? Do you want him to be your joy? What river? What is flowing? You see, we blame God so much. But we are not doing our part. Don't go and learn wisdom, you might be a Christian and end up inside the devil's camp. True. Because he said, my people perish for lack of knowledge. Do you know him? If you close your eyes and sleep this night, do you indeed know him? Will he show up for you? He said, my sheep hear me. They know me. There's no game of chance. Maybe he might. I don't like that word, maybe. It's not a good word. Maybe. The doctor said, I have this, I have that. Yes, it's a fact. But is it a truth? There is a fact, there is truth. He says Jesus is the way, the truth, and the life. So whatever life you have, there is a true life. No matter what life gives to you, there is another depth of life. This one we have has expiration date. But if you have the true life, when this one expires, you will continue. But you can combine the two. Walk in what he has been given. You will see the beauty of life. It's not, joy is not in the cars. Buy a brand new car, rock it for 6 months. I mean a baby, they call it baby when those men, you know, if you have men that love beautiful cars. When they buy a new one, they call it baby. This one is, you know, Porsche. They rock it, even the wife is not allowed to drive it anyhow. Only the days they are in the best of their mood. Then they can hand you the car key. And when it's getting old, you can drive it. Maybe there are two other ones that are new. Then you can take that one and go on your errand. Or he buy you your own. This one is my own. He loves that one more than you. That's what I'm telling you, a true love is trying. Go and take his brand new car, 2 days old. And say you're going to the market to buy fish and crayfish with it. And pack it and let the wheelbarrow man drag wheelbarrow on it. And they come back with that car. And there is a dent on it. Oh, you are dead. You are a dead woman. You will be panicking. You won't know how to go home. You say, oh honey, you will know that honey is tested. And honey is tried. But I want to tell you the love of Jesus is the one that has no ability to fail. In your frailty, in your weakness, he's the one that knows how to pamper you. He will show you the true love that never fades away. He will teach you like a baby in the kindergarten that you teach A, B, C, D. And he will be patient with you. When you miss it, he will correct you in love and tell you, daughter, you missed it. And then he will beg you to forgive yourself. Because sometimes pain of regret, you can't forgive yourself. And he will tell you that is in the past. Look forward. But then your honey will tell you, the other day you scratch my car. Today you're not allowed to drive it. Sorry, you disappointed me. If I give you another chance, you will blow it again. But when the pastor stood at the altar and said, he confessed that he will love you forever. So how come? How come he's giving up on you just like that? Because you scratch his new car, his new baby. Praise the Lord. So men, I'm not taking out on you, but I'm just telling the truth anyway. So don't be angry with me. Women too, you're like that. So it's all the same. No matter where the coin falls, we have no ability to give the kind of love that Jesus has given to us. Our own has limits. Our own comes with emotion, comes with feeling, comes with what we see, what we hear. If it tells us, oh, you're very sweet, you're very cute, the emotion rises. They tell us, how are you looking dirty like this? Are you following me? Why did you dress like that? Where are you going? Meanwhile, you people plan on going somewhere. And they ask you, where are you going like that? He said, now look for your own car. Make sure you don't tell people I know you. Because you're not looking sharp enough. The way he wants people to identify. But Jesus will identify with you, whether you look good or you don't look flashy. You know, women will go extra length to please, because God has wired us to love. It's in us. But even with all that, we still have a limit. But God is inexhaustible. He said, out of your belly shall flow ceaseless love. When you practice this in marriage, you have a sweet marriage. You keep flowing. You flow from your spirit and bless your marriage. If not, it will be cranky. The man will be cranky. The woman will be cranky, especially when there's no money. The man look at his pocket, there's no money. The woman look, Jesus. They look up, Jesus. Oh, Jesus. And then you start hearing Jesus 10 times in 1 minute. Jesus, that one, you won't know Jesus. Oh, Jesus, Jesus, Jesus. And then Jesus is going. And Jesus is standing looking. What do you want? Out of your spirit shall flow financial anointing to create increase you call deep things. Out of your belly, you call for new doors. Doors close sometimes. Job finish. Company can't sustain. Their money is finished. They say, workers, go home. You come home, you're shaking leg, going to GP. They are testing your temperature, testing your pressure, testing it, giving you some, you know, things to calm you down. But out of your belly shall flow peace. Peace. When you're troubled, where is your hope from? Your hope is in the Lord. When a man breaks your heart, what do you do? When a woman breaks your heart, some die. Yeah. Some get struck. I know cases. They're in wheelchair. Because the woman walked off and said, I'm not marrying again. I used to see you. I thought I loved you. But now, I can't find the love anymore. He didn't have it before. He had infatuation. He saw something. He couldn't explain. Now he can see clearly. Yeah, before he didn't see. Somehow you deceived him with your makeup, your beauty and everything. Now he know you a nag. You nag him at everything. He can't cope. But I want to tell you, there is something that has power to sustain marriage. There's something that has power to take you through deep trials, deep water, take you through sickness, take you through turbulence, is inside of you. Out of your belly shall flow success. Wisdom will spring up and tell you, son, do this now. In the next 3 years, change will come. In the next 6 months, that thing you see that is 1 euro now will become 10,000. Now, buy it. But if you know him, you will obey. If you don't know him, you say, waiting. You look back, it looks like somebody was talking at your back. You walk off. If you're blessed this afternoon, I want you to talk to him now. Talk to him. Tell him to be your helper. You have heard the message. You don't know how to use what you have heard. He has the power to teach you more. To break it down the way you understand it. That's why I love him. He's my teacher. Daily, I say, Lord, I'm at your feet teaching. How do I make today success? What should I do? All he needs to tell me that today will be tough. This and this and this and this and this. Now you need this, you need this. That doesn't stop things happening to you. But then you're fully prepared to handle it. You put on your peace, you put on your joy. And people are looking at you and you're smiling. But they know that deep things happen to you. And they're wondering how. Because you received the shock, but the pressure didn't get to you. It bounced back. You had a head knowledge, but the pain deep inside of you, he took it. He shielded your heart. Let's begin to thank him. Tell him, Lord, from now on, my desire is to find you. You are the life. You are the truth. You are all that I need. Teach me your ways. That's what Proverbs say. He said he has ways. Those that find his ways, they find life. Those that hate him, that are not looking for, they say they love death. God is life himself. Outside him, there is no life. The life we have has a limit. Precious Daddy.